Hey guys, welcome to another episode of On the Shelf, where I go through some of the trade paperbacks that I have on my shelf. We're basically starting from one side and going all the way down to the next, and each episode consists of basically a series of trades, if they're all collected in multiple volumes or if it's just one trade. Last time we talked about two kind of collections of Batman and Superman, and now we are officially going into my Batman collection. So I have single issue comics, but these are my trades that I look at every day on my shelf. Naturally, if we're going to start with Batman, we got to start with some origins. So we have Batman Year One. This is obviously one of the more go-to books when it comes to Batman. It is probably the go-to book. If people ask you, like, where should I start, this is probably what they're going to give you. Written by Frank Miller, art by David Mazzucchelli, which is amazing. They later went on to do, actually, I think it was beforehand, they went on to do Born Again with Daredevil, which we'll get to later. But yes, this book is a retelling of the origin of Batman, hence the Year One name, where it's the first year of Batman. And this book, you know, there have been many origins of Batman in the past. They've made some sense, and this is the one everyone seems to go back to. This is what inspired Batman Begins, and many, many other things. Actually, these tie into a lot of the standard run of Batman. A lot of people who write Batman now in the comics on a weekly basis tend to use this as the origin. So that's fun. Great book. As you can see, not super long. It was made up of, I don't remember how many issues it was when it first came out. I used to have them, four parts. It was a four-part story. Basically, it's the start. It tells the origin of Batman. So there's not a whole lot to discuss, but there's a lot of things that if you know the origin of Batman and you want to... if you know the origin of Batman and you got it from somewhere else besides this, it probably took inspiration from this. This is where we, this is as much a Jim Gordon story as it is a Batman story. We get introduced to Catwoman, who is actually in part of a prostitution ring. So, you know, this is where we get to the nitty gritty of the character. This is the very down to earth, not perfect Batman by any means. The art is fantastic by David Mazzucchelli. Really has a good grasp on what Batman would look like in his first year. One of the classic scenes, the ladies and gentlemen, you have eaten well scene. This was turned into a cartoon recently, which isn't too bad. Bryan Cranston does the voice of Commissioner Gordon, so you can watch that as well. But I highly recommend picking up this book. If you're looking to be a collector of trade paperbacks, or if you want to have... My goal in my trades is to have... kind of good highlights of each character that I like. So, for instance, Batman, you know, you want to have a lot of his highlights and some of the best written stuff, but also different chapters within his career. So you have, you know, Year One, and then eventually you get into you get into the Robin stuff. You get into, you know, later in his life, you get into Nightfall. You get into things like that. You get into the different Robins. So you want to have Tim Drake. He has a lot of chapters in his life and in his career that you can get to. So he has I have probably the biggest collection of Batman on, that's probably who I have the most books of, so it's going to take us a while to get through it, but this is, you know, if you want to collect like I do, and you want to have, like, you know, really good highlights about a character, Batman Year One is kind of a no-brainer. Obviously, there are many different ways to read this story. When we get to Superman, we're going to come to that conclusion as well, this is probably the best origin. I do have, you know, the original origin in one of my collections, but this just refined it and made him into the Batman we all know and love because of, you know, Frank Miller kind of set the standard, I think, for Batman, and people have just taken that and ran with it now, and, like, that's kind of what we look at now. We look at this Batman, and we've seen him grow up, and so this is always... Oh, just the way it's written, the internal dialogue of Batman talking, the internal dialogue of James Gordon, who isn't even commissioner yet, it feels kind of monotonous to talk about now because we've seen this Batman so much. We've seen this Batman in the movies, we've seen him in the comic books, and we've seen what he's turned into become now. I you know, they're going to get the inspiration of year one for the new Matt Reeves Batman coming out with Robert Pattinson as Batman. I'm sure they're going to take a lot from this. So it's kind of hard to talk about now compared to when it was, you know, when no one knew what was going on and where to start with Batman before those movies. If, you know, you only saw the, even if you only saw the animated series, which takes a lot from that as well, there isn't really a definitive origin in that. And, if you grew up with, you know, obviously the Michael Keaton stuff, they also take some of the tone inspiration, but the origin is completely different. So it was easier to explain this, but the Batman that you probably love came from this book. So must have in the collection. This is an older edition. This is, you can see the old early 2000s DC logos on it. I picked this up when I really started to get into collecting trades, and it's a pretty good version. It's really good quality. Obviously, this is pretty old. This is probably printed in the early 2000s, and it looks brand new. And it's not, I take care of my stuff pretty well, and, you know, I don't read these books constantly, but the cool thing about this is at the end you get a lot of fun extras. So you get, you know, the story ends, and I won't spoil that because you really want to see what happens, but get a lot of afterwards David Mazzucchelli art. You get some fun little bits and pieces of where they came for the ideas. You have some of David Mazzucchelli's first comic page from when he was a kid, from the 60s. A lot of inspirations, a lot of sketches. So it's always fun to see that stuff, and it's fun when they add that to these kind of books. So I think a lot of the versions now that you can get have that kind of stuff. They do have hardbound versions. They have deluxe versions now. So if you're looking for something a little bit better, you can do that. But so yeah, Batman Year One. If you have any questions about this book, leave comments down below. I'll answer them to the best of my ability. As I said in the last video, this one's a little bit better because it's a definitive book to talk about, and those were just collections. But we're going to start getting into more interesting things to talk about with some of these as we go along, because these are just kind of the staples. I mean, when we talk about Watchmen, or when we talk about Dark Knight Returns, or if we talk about things like that, that's where they are going to be harder to discuss because everyone talks about them. I can't wait to get some of the books that you may have not read that I want to recommend for you. So we'll get there, but we are just at the top of the shelf, and we have a long ways to go. So that was On the Shelf with Stranded J. Hope you enjoyed it. Like I said, if you have any questions, leave them below, down below, and I will see you guys on the next video.